Hello student, welcome to EPG Parshala. Myself Dr. Baljinder Singh Gill, and I will discuss with you the module that is nanocleanizing and nano bioremediation, that is under the paper that is nano biotechnology. So let us start with the topic by introduction. So before starting this chapter, we will discuss about the concept of biodegradation and bioremediation. Biodegradation is to degrade environmental pollutant by use of microorganism or living organism. So biodegradation is a natural process, and biodegradation is of mainly further, it is a general term, and it includes two terms, that is biotransformation and biomineralization. Biotransformation is transformation of pollutant into another form. It may be, for example, any other metabolites, one or two metabolites. Biomineralization means that is a complete mineralization of pollutant or substance by the microorganism. That is release of carbon dioxide if it is a carbon oxygen organic compound, or release of nitrogen or release of chlorine if the parent compound contain this chlorine or this nitrogen. So also biodegradation, because organism are involved in biodegradation. So biodegradation is that microorganism, they may use this environmental pollutant or this organic compound or any substance for their growth. So they use this pollutant as a sole source of carbon, nitrogen or energy, or they may also another term that is co-substrate, or whether they produce any extracellular enzyme or the machinery for the removal or for the degradation of this compound, then it is called co-substrate. And bioremediation, it is a engineered term, it is not a natural process. Bioremediation, it is the use of microorganism or the living organism to neutralize the organic pollutant, especially organic or environmental pollutant. So the bioremediation, it is also called bioreclamation, biorestoration. Okay, now the bioremediation, if we use the plant for the removal of this environmental pollutant, then it is called phytoremediation term. Then for the, if we are using fungus, bioremediation is also used. So bioremediation is also of two type. One is in situ and second one is ex situ. In situ, that is in the site, contaminated sites, the various microorganism or the living organism are used for the to neutralize the environmental pollutant. It may be the bioventing, bioaugmentation. These are some of the other term that is related to this in situ bioremediation. Ex situ, where we have use the laboratory condition for the remediation or some other site for the remediation of this environmental pollutant. So here we use the term nano bioremediation because nanoparticle, they are used for the remediation of this organic for the remediation of this environmental pollutant. And this nanoparticle, because of their unique characteristics, they have the property of so that we can use it as a nano bioremediations. So in this chapter, regarding the learning outcome or the objective, in this chapter we will discuss the concept of nano bioremediation, and also the various nanoparticles which are used for the bioremediation of pollutant, and also the mechanism, because nano zero valent and they are most commonly used. What are the mechanism of this? How the nano zero valent ion, they can remove the or they can perform the bioremediation. So in this chapter, we will also discuss the biogenic nanoparticles, how the nanoparticles from this living organism, they can combat with the environmental pollutant under the nanobioremediation. So let us start with the chapter of the module. Now the nanoparticle, they have the property to combat with the environmental pollutant. So this nanoparticle from the yeast, bacteria or fungus, if we use this biogenic nanoparticle, because the source is living organism and they also act as a nanofactories. They are called the nanofactory because the nanoparticle, they are prepared from this sources, living organism sources. Now this nanoparticle, the most various nanoparticle which are used for the remediation, they are maybe the CNT, carbon nanotubes, titanium dioxide also, metal based nanoparticle also. But most commonly used nanoparticle which is used as a nanobioremediation, it is a zero valent ion, which is most commonly used for the bioremediation. Also this, it is a recent method and it is also involved the green nanobiotechnology. Nanobioremediation, it means nanoparticles are involved for the remediation of pollutants. Now this slide actually shows the application of nanomaterial in bioremediation. They have the application in the field of solid waste remediation. They have also application in the field of groundwater and wastewater remediation. And they have also in the hydrocarbon remediation, uranium remediation, and the heavy metal pollution remediation. So nanoparticle, they also play a role in the bioremediation. That bioremediation, that is the removal of organic pollutant, or it may be the heavy metal or any pollutant, by using the biological method. But when we inserted or prepared nanoparticle from this biological material, then the term is used, that is called the nanobioremediation. Now why nanoparticle are used as a bioremediation? Because they have the unique properties, like they have the semiconducting, they have nano size, high surface to volume ratio, and these are the photocatalysts. These are some of the property, that is why the nanoparticle are used as a nanobioremediation. Now second thing, that is these nanoparticles, they can diffuse or penetrate into the contamination zone because of their nano size, where the microparticle, they can't reach. So they have higher reactivity to redox amenable contaminants. Now the common example is oxide coated iron. They can form a very weak and outer sphere complex with the contaminant, and any contaminant that come in contact with that, they can be broken down into a chemical with a lower toxicities in the batch experiment and in the field assessment. So these are the example of why the nanoparticle are used. That is due to their chemical property, their unique properties, their characteristic properties. Now what are the main examples of nanobioremediations? First one is the metal nanoparticle. For example, platinum, it can be deposited on the cell wall and inside the cytoplasm of this organism, that is the Salmonella, that's onadidis, and charged with the radical by adding different substrates such as the hydrogen acetate and formate as electron donors. And when this charged platinum, that is platinum zero, it is deposited on the cells of this organism, they are brought in contact with the chlorinated compound, and this radical on the platinum, they catalytically react with the pentachlorophenol, which result in the removal of chlorine. because there is a removal of chlorine, there is a complete mineralization of this compound. So the nanoparticle, that is a metal nanoparticle, they have the property of nanobioremediation. Other example, researcher, they have also found the fungal nanoparticles for the removal of oil pollution also. They have prepared the nanoparticle from the various fungus which have the biodegradation capability for degrading oil or the polyaromatic hydrocarbons also. And researcher, they prepared from nanoparticle from such species for the removal of, for the efficient removal of oil pollutions. Now the nanoparticle, they can be further used to immobilize microbial cell that can degrade or biorecover specific chemicals. Unlike conventional cell mobilization, magnetic nanoparticle, for example, that is a Fe3O4, it has been functionalized with ammonium oleate and coated on the surface of this bacteria Pseudomonas. And when by applying an external magnetic field to this microbial cell, this magnetic nanoparticle coated cell, they concentrated at a specific location of the reactor wall. And now this can be separated from the bulk solution and recycled for the treatment of same substrate. So it is a, by use of this nanoparticle for bioremediation, it is a efficient method, because as we have already discussed, any efficient method, they require the recycle of treatment agent, cost effective and highly efficient. So this fulfill the condition of that, actually meet that full or fulfill the condition of that efficient, that is efficient treatment method. Now these microbial cell, they have demonstrated to desulfurize organic sulfur from fossil fuel, that is dibenzothiophene, as effectively as known nanoparticle coated cells. Now the very important example of this bioremediation is a nanoscale zero valent iron. It is a very common example, because iron, they have the, in the aqueous solution, they have the potential to undergo oxidation to form ferrous, then ferric, and any pollutant that come in close proximity to this iron particle, they undergo the reduction process. And in the bioremediation, it is most commonly used, that is a nanoscale zero valent iron, because they have low standard reduction potential and favorable quantum size properties and potential increase in transport efficiency through groundwater underground matrix. And this nanoscale zero valent iron, they have also properties that enable both chemical reduction and catalysis to mitigate a variety of pollutant of concern, including chlorinated compounds like also the organochlorine pesticides and polychlorinated biphenyls, heavy metals and inorganic anions. So in the contaminated sources, nanoscale zero valent ion, they are likely to be transformed from iron zero to ferrous ion state and then undergo the further oxidative transformation to the ferric ion. Now the groundwater and the surface water, that is it. Now the, we will explain the mechanism behind the bioremediation by using this nanoscale zero valent iron. Now the groundwater and the surface water corrosion for nanoparticle or zero valent ion, it can be explained by the following example. For example, iron reacts with water to form this ferrous ion, and ferrous ion can be further transformed to the, by the following reaction, into the ferric ion by the oxidative transformations. And this ferrous iron, this has been shown to be most toxic state of the iron for the microorganism and also for the invertebrates. But it will rapidly convert into ferric ion under the neutral and in the alkaline environment. And in the deep underground, that is aqueous organisms, where the oxygen is limited, iron, that is zero elemental iron, it is likely to be converted into either magnetite or into the megahematite, depending upon the oxidation condition. We have already discussed in the previous module that the magnetite and the megahematite, the metal oxide, they are also used for the removal of air as well as the water pollutants. Now, the capability of this powdered or the zero valent ion, as we have already mentioned, they have the capability to remove the chlorinated compound, for example, that is a organochlorine pesticide, and polychlorinated biphenyls. They are capable of removing or dechlorinate. Dechlorinate means that is removal, that is a complete mineralization of DDT and the related compounds, that is the DDT, DDE, that is 2,2-biparachlorophenyl-1,1-dichloroethylenes. Now this diagram, they are showing the bioremediation capability of, that is the nanoscale zero valent iron, where they have the capability to dechlorination of organic solvent, bimetallic nanoparticle like platinum and iron. They have also the capability for the removal of this organic solvent or that is the organic pollutant. They have also the this carbon nanotubes. They can also be used for the detoxification of pesticide, especially the organochlorine pesticide like lindane, DDT. And there is also the capability of metals, that is a core shell nanocomposite, where the nanoparticles that are incorporated to the thin films, they have also the capability, because mainly the heavy metals, they are incorporated on the surface or on the thin film composite. They have the capability for the removal of heavy metals by immobilization method. That is the dispersed nanoparticle. They have also capability for transformation of this fertilizer also. Now this is the example of bioremediation. By injecting the nanoscale zero valent iron, we can enhance the bioremediation of these sites. Single enzyme nanoparticle in bioremediation. Enzyme, because of their proteinaceous nature or the macromolecule, they lose their stability, longevity also, and they lose their function. When this enzyme lost their function, the researcher tried to, that is, incorporate the nanoparticle or interact nanoparticle with the enzyme for their longevity, to increase their stability, to increase their reuse or the recycle also. So the mainly researcher, they use the magnetic nanoparticles, and the magnetic nanoparticle, they can be easily separated by using the phenomenon that is a magnetism at the end of use of this enzyme. Now these are some of the common example shown in the tabular form. What are the contaminated source? For example, preferable sink of that is a water, soil, and air. Now here is the contaminated source is a groundwater, and the contaminant that are present, they are the chlorinated compound. And applied treatment is the injection of nanoscale zero valent iron in the subsurface, and it is a bioremediation method where the success rate is 96% of this chlorinated compound have been removed by over a time of 4 weeks. Similarly, heavy metals, they can be removed by using the nano particle composite or thin film composite. That is study that is done under the laboratory where the water quality, they meet the standard of the WHO, that is World Health Organization. Similar, these are another slide which are also showing the compound which have the capability, nanoparticle, for example, iron, copper and nickel, that is the metal nanoparticle. Similarly, titanium dioxide and the nanomembrane, they have the capability for the removal of nitrate, cation. This we have already discussed in the module where we have discussed the nanoparticle for the removal of these water pollutants. Now, crude oil spill, hydrocarbon, they can also be removed by the nano-sized calcium oxide nanoparticle. Similarly, the endocrine disruptor like the bisphenol A, it can also be removed by the magnetite hybrid nanoparticle. And we know the magnetite hybrid nanoparticle, they can be easily separated after the treatment or after the operation condition by using the, that is a magnetic effect or the magnetic phenomena. Now, next is the green or the biogenic nanoparticle. These are the, because nowadays green nanoparticle or the green nanochemistry is a term mainly used for the development of cost effective as well as the environmental acceptable nanoparticle which are used for the removal of, whether they have an application in the field of environmental agriculture or in the field of in the field of pharmaceutical also. Now, the microorganism and the plant extract, they are mainly used for the synthesis of this nanoparticle. Now, the microbial enzyme as well as the plant phytochemicals, that are the, it may be the phytochemical, it may be the any flavonoid, secondary metabolite or the primary metabolite, mainly primary secondary metabolite or the, that is the pigment or the, these are the example of phytochemical. Also the, for example, chlorophyll and other, that is a pigment, which are the example of plant phytochemicals, which have antioxidant property or the reducing property. They are mainly used for the reduction of metal compound to their reactive nanoparticle, into their respective nanoparticle also. So the advantage of using this plant, it is easily available, safe to handle, possess a broad wire, that is a variability of metabolites that may aid in the reduction process. While fungus or the bacteria, they require a comparatively longer incubation time for the reduction of metal ions as compared to the phytochemicals. Now, using plant tissue culture technique and also by the using downstreaming processing procedure, it is easily and it is possible to synthesize metallic as well as the oxide nanoparticle on a industrial scale application. So the green or the biogenic nanoparticle is nothing, that is a nanoparticle that are prepared from the living organism. For example, plant extract are mainly used, as well as the microbial secretion or the microbes are also used, in even the fungal or the fungus are also used for the preparation of this nanoparticle, because these are the living organism, that is why they are called the biogenic nanoparticle, and it comes under the field of green nanoparticle or green chemistry nanoparticle. So the they have a lot of advantages because they are environmental acceptable as well as they are the cost effective. Now, these are generalized flow chart of for the nano biosynthesis. So for the biosynthesis of nanoparticle, we if we use the bacteria, fungus, plant part, any which have the bioremediation capability or which have the antioxidant property, they can be prepared by using the solution chemistry or interaction time. These are the parameters that are required for the preparation of these particles, and their physiochemical characterization that are mainly done by the various techniques like स्कैनिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी, ट्रांसमिशन इलेक्ट्रॉन माइक्रोस्कोपी, एक्सआरडी, एंड दीज आर द सम ऑफ द, एंड आल्सो आफ्टर इफ द नैनो पार्टिकल दे मीट द फिजियोकेमिकल करेक्टराइजेशन और द दे आर कैपेबल ऑफ रिमूविंग द पोल्यूटेंट बाय यूजिंग बायोरेमेडिएशन, देन दे आर बायोफंक्शनलाइजेशन इज डन, एंड इफ दे आर नॉट देन द वी विल मॉडिफाई द प्रोसेस ऑफ देयर बायो सिंथेसिस, बिकॉज स्टेबिलिटी इज वन ऑफ द मेन फैक्टर इन द सिंथेसिस ऑफ दिस नैनो पार्टिकल बाय यूजिंग द दिस लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. These are the examples. This table, in the tabular form, the various nanoparticle that are prepared from the plant extract. For example, the plant, various plant which have the medicinal, mainly the medicinal plant file, that is phalanthium mushroom, rose plant also, coriandrum sativum. These are the citrus family also, from where the gold or the silver nanoparticle are prepared. Similarly, silver nanoparticle, they are prepared from aloe vera extract, capsicum, anum. These all are the mainly the these are the medicinal plant or the plant which have a higher antioxidant activity, which show the higher antioxidant activity. Higher the antioxidant activity, or that is come mainly comes under the medicinal plant, because medicinal plant they show higher antioxidant activity. Now the gold nanoparticle, the example are the banana peel, and other are Allium sepa. These are the Komal camilla sinensis. These are the tea plant. These are the common examples, Chenopodium album, from where the gold nanoparticle are appeared. And similarly, these are the another example of plant extract, for example, lead nanoparticle prepared from the Zetrofa plant and Vitis vinifera, and magnetic nanoparticle again they can be prepared from the plant aloe vera. The main advantages of using this green nanotechnology, it is reduces the cost, it increases the effectivity, low toxicity, and also enhance the bioremediation. Moreover, it is also environmental more environmental acceptable technique for the remediation of or for the bioremediation of environmental pollutant. Now what are the future trends that can be used for the removal of this pollutant? The researcher they actually should synthesize the nanoparticle from the polymer such as polyethylene glycol, that is a widely used compound found in laxative, toothpaste, eye drops, and polylactic, another compound that are biodegradable plastic, that is used in the compostable cups and glassware. These polymers and the polylactic acid, they are approved by the Food and Drug Administration, because means they are safe for the human health. Therefore, the nanoparticle made from these polymers, they have, because Food and Drug Administration, they have proved the concentration and they have proved the such polymers that can be used for this preparation of this toothpaste or any other cosmetic agent or any other medicals. Okay, so nanoparticle made from this polymer, they have the hydrophobic core and hydrophilic shell. Due to their molecular scale forces in the solution, hydrophobic pollutant remove molecules, it move toward the hydrophobic nanoparticle and adsorb on to the outer their surface, whereas they become effectively trapped, and these nanoparticles they remained in the suspended and dispersed in the water. But when we exposed this nanoparticle agglomerate to the UV light, the stabilizing outer shell which contain the this pollutant, the shell of the particle, they shed, and the pollutant they form the large aggregate which can be removed through the filtration, sedimentation, and other method for that are a part of primary treatment method also. So welcome student, now we will summarize the module. That is, we have already discussed the various nanoparticles which are used for the bioremediation of environmental pollutant, and in the future trend of future trends for the this nano bioremediation. We have discussed about the use of this nano particle that is prepared from the polymer or from the other compound which have been proved by the Food and Drug Administration, and from where the nanoparticle can be prepared, which have both the hydrophobic and hydrophilic shell, and the pollutant they clump together, and it can be easily shed by the various technique like UV treatment. So in the this chapter we have already also discussed the various biogenic nanoparticles which can be used, because these nanoparticles they can be prepared from the various plant extract, also from the living organism or from the microorganism secretion also, so they are environmental acceptable. We have already discussed also the that is the non-zero valent ion, that is nano zero valent ion, how they remove the dechlorinate the organochlorine pesticide, which are mainly banned nowadays. No doubt the organochlorine pesticides they are banned in the country, but organophosphate pesticides are used, as researchers they try to remove this organophosphate pesticide by using this nano bioremediation method also. So with the development of this technique, nanotechnology, they tried to develop a green nanobiotechnology by using biogenic nanoparticles. That's all about this chapter. Thank you very much.